In the 1970s to the 1990s, the Canadian federal government worked with our provinces to build social housing for our country's citizens. It was 30% of your income. Families thrived and could afford a life for their children. Housing gave hope and dignity to single parents. It built community, safety, and security. It was the promise, the helping hand from our governments to a citizen in need. 25 years later, we're in the middle of one of the greatest housing crises the province of BC has ever faced.
Crisis is a good word to use. The federal government and the provincial government at the end of the 1990s abandoned social housing.
There was no further investments. They haven't actually built any social housing for the past decade or more.
Under this government, we have seen homelessness rise, affordability go down, poverty increase.
That is the most crucial question, right? How do we design social housing that meets people's needs, that allows people to live with dignity and freedom?
We're investing $2.3 billion to support the housing needs of our citizens across Canada.
And it includes homelessness outreach programs that are not about physical starts of housing. So how much money is going to be put towards building brand new social housing?
I get frustrated with layers of bureaucracy on projects that need to happen 10 years ago. And not just paying lip service to engagement with stakeholders.
BC Liberals attacked impoverished citizens with a double-edged sword. They cut health care, slashed mental health outreach, and sliced social housing, creating an unsustainable rise of homelessness in our province. Super Intense City made poverty public. A community was formed by Victoria's homeless that exposed the need for safe community in response to a negligent government.
My name is Logan, and I'm the Anglican Bishop. And I've been inspired by what I see here in the tent city to look at long-term transformational change.
As soon as I started seeing tents go up, I started paying attention to what was happening at the courthouse. As they were able to stay, more people went because we have a homeless problem in Victoria.
People had shown up on the lawn because it was a place where they could take refuge. People weren't getting kicked out every morning because it was not subject to the 7-7 bylaws.
It was peaceful, it was safe, people had nowhere else to go. They were building community.
There was people that were going to work every day, rebuilding their lives because they had the community support.
During the 10 months Tent City existed, Housing Minister Rich Coleman pushed Tent City into court, forcing residents into one temporary shelter after another.
Shelters are not homes!
Shelters are not homes!
Not homes! They're institutions!
Citizens were thrown into an unprepared and unsafe environment. The health of our citizens in these institutions is at risk daily. And the proof lies in the 5 deaths that have occurred over the past 10 months under the care of the BC Liberal government within the walls of 844 Johnson. Everybody has a right to be with their community. It doesn't matter what they're doing. If they're out in the world and they have the right to be out in the world, they have a right to housing. And I believe that when people are in community together, they do better.